Ready? Start. The revenue being aggrieved by the decision of the board filed tax revision petition before the High Court under Section 86 of the Act. The High Court dismissed the revision petition filed by the revenue and upheld the decision of the board by holding that the respondent unit is a prestigious unit and therefore entitled to 75% tax exemptions under the scheme. Aggrieved by the order so passed by the High Court, the revenue is before us in this appeal. We have heard learned counsel for the parties to the case and perused the documents on record as well as the order passed by the authorities and the High Court respectively. The learned senior counsel appearing for the appellant submits that the case pleaded by respondent unit right from the beginning of filing the application before the state level screening committee was that the new unit had made an investment of more than rupees 500 crores by way of fixed capital assets and therefore they should be placed under the category of prestigious unit and accordingly be granted eligibility certificate to claim 75% of the exemption from tax for the maximum time limit provided under the scheme. In aid of this submission, the learned senior counsel would draw our attention to the application and the accompanying affidavit filed by the respondent unit before the state level screening committee. He would further contend that the respondent unit before all the authorities below including the High Court had adopted the stand that the fixed capital investment excluding investment made before 5th March 1997 was more than rupees 530 crores and therefore the respondent unit is a prestigious unit entitled to an exemption of 75% of total tax liability. It is further contended that the respondent new unit being new cement unit and further being large scale unit though can avail the benefit of the incentive scheme under 1E of Annexure C which provides for exemption up to 25% of total liabilities, it cannot avail the benefit of exemption at the rate of 75% under item 4 as prestigious unit. He would further submit that benefit to cement industry is confined to the extent envisaged under the item 1E of Annexure C as the said item is a specific provision relating to cement industry. Alternatively, it is contended that the respondent unit being new cement unit, it may fall under new very prestigious unit. However, item 5 of Annexure C speaks of the new very prestigious units other than cement units except those located in subplan area. Respondent unit may not be entitled to avail the benefit of the scheme. Per contra, learned counsel would justify the reasoning and the conclusion reached by the High Court while rejecting the revenue's revision petition and thereby confirming the view expressed by the board. He would inter alia submit that item 1E is only an exception to the general rule envisaged in item 1 and not an exception to the other items in the Annexure C items 2 to 7 as it is not intended to govern the entire field of exemptions made available to the cement industry so as to deny the benefits to a unit even if it falls under another item envisaging better incentives. He would further submit that since new cement unit is specific Kali excluded from application of item 1, item 2 and item 5 but not item 4, 6 and item 7, it follows that the intention behind such express exclusion is such that but for the said exclusion, Cement Industries would be included in the said entries. He would strenuously submit that since the tax exemption clauses are made with a beneficent object to encourage investment in specified rural semi-urban areas, their construction must be liberal such as to confer the most beneficial meaning to the provisions. The facts which are not in dispute are that the respondent assessee established a new cement unit within Panchayat Samiti and commenced commercial production sometime in the year 1997. It engaged itself in the manufacture of cement. The total capital investment in the new industrial unit claimed by the company was Rs. 532 crores. The company had applied for grant of eligibility certificate for exemption from payment of central sales tax and Rajasthan sales tax before the state level screening committee Jaipur under the scheme. However, the screening committee accepted only rupees 55.32 crores as FCI eligible for availing the benefits under the scheme. On the aforesaid basis, the state-level screening committee certified that the company is entitled to avail exemption of tax to the extent of 25% of the tax liability by treating the same to be a large-scale industry. In the appeal, the board took the view it has the status of new prestigious unit. This falls within the definition.